Buenos días, mi gente. How's everyone doing? I just started coming right away and do a quick live and share with you guys how I do my Coquito recipe. Many of you have asked me, and I'm going to demonstrate to you a very simple one. You don't have to boil water. You don't have to get the clove sticks or the cinnamon sticks. That's an extra step. But if you want to have an instant Coquito that you can refrigerate for 15, 30 minutes in me, freeze and then have it ready for your guests. This is the one. So let's start really quick. I was having all kinds of issues. I'm not even sure you guys can hear me because I left my computer charge in my other place. So I'm not even sure you guys can hear me. Anyway, here we go. So, hey Alexa, play some Et tu la voix Christmas music. You have that?
Here's a station you might like. Holiday favorites on Amazon Music.
Let's see. Ooh. Okay, Alexis, stop. That's not Hector Labo. Feliz Navidad. Alexa, please play Hector Labo's Christmas music. Let's see if there's such thing.
Shuffling Christmas songs by Hector Labo.
Yay!
Amazon Music.
All right, here we go, mi gente. We're gonna start with the coconut cream. This is very thick. Everybody don't mind this is like a big can, but I couldn't find the big one, so I bought this little one. So this one is 6 ounces each, or a 12-ounce can of coconut cream. Woo! Repa! We're gonna add in 1 can of the evaporated milk. There we go. And now we're gonna move quickly to the condensed milk. Now this one is called for a whole can. I don't use the whole can of condensed milk only because it's too sweet. And mempalaya, it's too much. So what we're gonna do maybe, get, eyeball it. I cannot eyeball it for my taste, so I'll show you how much I put. That is okay for me. A lot of people like it very sweet, I don't. So that's about how much I put in, not even quite half a can of that condensed milk. And of course, one cup of the best rum, Ron Don Cool, Puerto Rican rum. Here we go. Or Bacardi, it could be either way. Y el jibarito cantando. So we're gonna add here a little bit of a pat of vanilla to your taste too. Woo! Some ginger, I like to add ginger, just like a tad. Not too much, because you guys know ginger is strong. Okay, cinnamon, also a dash, a tad, whatever you guys feel comfortable. So here you go. Woo. Oh, and I also like to add coconut milk also, you know, here you go. These are the brands that I found in Stop and Shop. The best brand, llegó. Here we go. A little bit of coconut milk. And now the party's gonna start. You know, this recipe, because I'm using a thick coconut cream, it calls for like 30 minutes to leave it in the blender. So what I do, I start the blender. And I cannot check. I don't leave the whole thing for 30 minutes. It will be too much. Here we go. So leave it there for 2 seconds. I'll be right back because I just noticed something is about to die, and I will go offline. This baby now, it's gonna take a while. Alessa, stop please. Okay, let's see. Ooh, it's thick. So we have to let that baby. Let's try a little bit. I like to try it. You might need a little bit more room. These things always gets me. Here we go. Ching, ching, ching. Si a mí me encanta, I love to make it foamy, espumoso, very smooth. I love it. Be a more rum. Ooh, here you go. Oh, you know what? I also like to add a tad of salt. Not a lot. So it breaks down a little bit of the sweet from the condensed milk. All right, baby girl. Come on. Feel up. Na 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 día, mi gente. Espero que todos estén bien. How's everyone enjoying the holiday? Alexa, play Haciendo Punto en Otro Son Music.
Shuffling songs by Haciendo Punto and Otro Son.
That's right, Alexa. You're getting better in your Spanish, Alexa.
You're getting in Spanish is. Estás consiguiendo.
Oh, that sounds very good. You're learning pretty quick. Your algorithms are improving, Alexa. That's great. So what you got for me? Alexa, where did you go? Haciendo Punto Son.
I'm here, ready to answer your questions.
Yeah, where's my music? Alexa, play Haciendo Punto en Otro Son. Message gets a
medley Haciendo Punto, Enciando Mi Caballo,
yeah.
Blues, La Vida Todo Es Ayer, Uba Moy by Tony Croato, featuring Silverio Perez on Amazon Music.
That's the one. Play the music. Who loves to play with Siri and Alexa? I do. Siguiendo mi caballo, mi negra se echó a llorar. Y yo llorando con ella lo voy a desencillar. Do a little bit more. Let's get in there. I'm going to add a little bit of more condensed milk. Criolla enciende el espíritu. Bueno, mi gente, yo creo que ya esto está listo. ¿Vieron lo fácil que es? ¿Cuánto me eché? ¿Cuánto llevo en vivo? No, ni sé. 5 o 6 minutos. That's how quick this coquito can be made. So just remember, 1 can of condensed milk, 1 can of evaporated milk, 1 can of cream of coconut, like Coco Lopez or any other brand, 1 can of coconut milk. I like to add a tap of salt, cinnamon, some ginger, and also vanilla. And that's pretty much it. And then you blend everything and you let it chill. You gotta make sure that the coconut gets kind of like breaking down. And of course, we cannot forget the 1 cup of alcohol, right? The rum. Woo! Woo! I got water with alcohol. Yes, yes, though. My goodness. Here we go. Doncella, quiero. Okay, Alexa, stop. At this time also, I want to take the opportunity. I'm gonna smell like alcohol now. I dump a little bit of a rum in me. Ooh. So I just wanted to share with you quick. It's actually, this life is for Manny Ruiz and Carlos Phoenix, my friends. Why I'm making this special life for them? Because yesterday I read a posting on Facebook that Manny posted, Manny Ruiz, that he was actually sharing with us his impression of the movie Don't Look Up, which I have heard that is kind of like on the talks, you know, in the background noise everywhere, but I have not really taken the chance to take a look at this movie or to even know what is it about. So when I saw the commentary from Manny Ruiz and then Carlos, and of course everybody's sharing different perspective, it's like Manny Ruiz said today, of course the movie now is gonna be fucking popular for the comments that we're sharing. Like he said, it's gonna become popular because the good thing about this publicity in a way is that we're talking about this movie. And I watched it twice. The first time I kind of fell asleep because I was very tired. I started watching it late at night, so I couldn't stay up. But yesterday in early afternoon, I sat down and I gave it the 2 hours, my whole attention to this movie. And I have to say that surprisingly, I liked it. I really enjoyed it. I thought it was quite entertaining. And in a way, to me, kind of like it was music to my ears, because as a person that gave at least all her mind in the community for over 25 years, working as an advocate, as a community representative, case manager, the whole shebang, and sort of kind of like being around the parameters, even inside sometimes or outside of a legislative body for government, and also from the community, looking from the inside, from the outside, what that movie did is pretty much, to me, I saw like a parody, a satire of the stuff that are currently going on in the nation. How we, a hateful speech or any speech that is shared in the interest on some kind of either money or some kind of propaganda that is gonna benefit any either side. This is the kind of tactic, this is the kind of engagement that they use to get people's attention. So what this movie did for me was, in a way, it's like an educational tool, so it can show the rest of we the people, for the people, by the people, that we really need to get involved in our local communities, government, you know, on your city council, or your county legislator, your senator, your congressman. You ask the people, ask the person, we the people for the people, the government of the people, we all are. You are responsible to get involved in your government and see how are these people are making decisions for you as a community of interest. Are they representing your core values? Are they representing, or are they actually working on the promises that they kind of romance you or lure you to give them their vote? So if anyone understands a little bit of politics by now, politics runs in gossip. It's all propaganda. They're not really actually the people that are running for government, okay? A lot of people are great people, a lot of candidates. They go there with their heart and soul in wanting to make a contribution to our country or to the respective community. But in reality, it's a marriage of convenience, because when you go in there, you can go with a sword to, like I said, chop heads, trying to kind of like make it right or make the right decision for your community. But the mambo is not easy to play, okay? Because there are already people there, you're the newbie coming in, and you have to work with those people. You have to try to figure it out where is a happy medium. In politics, it's not easy, especially when we have a populace, a citizenry, that is ridden with a lot of the ignorance that the politics, the propaganda feed the people. And when people are coming from a place that they're lacking that awareness of how the politician and the political machine works, of course they're going to engage in the tools to try to create that divisiveness in the people. And most of the time, those individuals are coming from a place that are totally devoid of what? Consciousness. Because they are driven by one purpose only, and that's profit making. And this movie did a really great job showing that. Look, at the end, they could have done something right to save the planet or mankind from extinction. But there's some person came up with the idea that they could make trillions of money in how to harness whatever minerals or resources this comet that was about to hit the Earth was potential. All speculations, profit-driven. And guess what happened? You guys got to see the movie. But I will suggest that watch this movie, open-hearted, free of politics, free of propaganda, and just really see it from a clean canvas, like an educational tool. Because if one thing entertainment industry can do, since we the people for the people, by the people, a vast majority, we don't really follow or do our due diligence as citizens to actually be the people of the government and be in charge of our elected representative and supervise them, monitor them. Monitor them. You know, just like when you hire somebody, if you're a boss and you're running a company and you're hiring a vice president, you're hiring a manager, you're hiring somebody in the assembly line, everybody requires supervision and monitoring, right? So when you're good giving a job to an elected representative, okay, to represent you, you're hiring that individual with your vote. So it is your responsibility for you to actually supervise your employee, supervise your mayor, supervise your senator, supervise your congressman, supervise your ward member, your council leader. You, the people, by the people, for the people, you're responsible to supervise and hold accountable your elected officials when on record, not in public propaganda, meaning the stuff that they're saying, they can look at the record. Nowadays, more than ever, it's so much easier. You don't even have to go to the legislative body, legislation, let's say. You don't even have to go to the Senate. Everything is online. Anything you like to know how your senator, congressman, your mayor, your council leader, whatever you watch, you might call it, as to the structure of your local government, everything is on paper. The government runs on paper. Talking about paper, right? They want to, they could probably make all the money they want to. But anyway, what I'm saying is, this movie, I thought it was really entertaining because I saw it as a parody, as a satire of the today's current events and affairs that happens around the country when we get polarized about politics and how the media and politics, which is a marriage of convenience made in heaven, they manipulate the populace. So it's up to us for us to be awake, to be conscious, to listen with the heart. So when you're listening to your politician, you're not only looking at them and hear, you feel the words, you can feel their words in your heart. You can feel, is that person aligned with my vibration, with my frequency of benevolence? That's the kicker. Are we conscious enough? Are we mindfully, civically engaged enough that we understand how the politics of our government is wrong? And there's not going to be that many changes. There's always going to be passing the ball. Democrats, gotcha, Republicans turn, and the ball game keeps going. But not until we get in the mirror, start catching those balls. I say, hey, wait a minute, was that, what kind of ball was that? That was uncalled for, whatever. I'm just trying to use sports analogy. But what I'm trying to say is, it is our responsibility for us to supervise and monitor our elected officials. If we don't do it, who does? A vote is not enough. Just giving the vote and go register and vote, that's not it. They just do that to get you the vote because they need the numbers so they can cut the pie later and then they can figure out how they're going to manipulate the populace. But it's up to you that once you give them the vote, you got to be out there and say, yo, Yoni, or little Mary, let's see how are you doing in blah, 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 that this is what I care for. This is what you offer when you were running your platform. So I just want to take a look at. So mi gente, just like everything else, you keep an eye on, you keep an eye on your marriage, you keep an eye on your children, right? You keep an eye on this good stuff that you like to do for your family, or when you're working any private, what do? You take pride, you stay on top of the game. That's the same way you gotta be with your elected representative. The greatest disservice that our government has done to we the people, for the people, by the people, is to take away our understanding and our confidence that we are in charge of them. It's not the other way around. Think about it, people. All these people elected this person, right? Some person, whatever. And that makes them that you are that person because you gave them the job. So it is your job to supervise and monitor, not the other way around. They're just gonna get lost inside the house and deals with whatever dynamics are in there. And a place of govern, that's not where a lot of grace abounds. So it is up to us to bring the grace into our political body, into our government. So if you wanna have grace in the White House, you start monitoring your elected officials. Are they leading with grace? Are they leading with a conscious heart? Are they really leading from a place that is devoid of the greed, of the political propaganda, of the kind of speech that they want to divide the country? We have to hold them accountable. So it's up to us, we the people, for the people, by the people. And having shown that, Manny and Carlos, I like the movie, but again, I liked it for the reason I didn't even care about the player. Yes, you're right. Great A-list, but I think it was a good resource because sometimes people don't pay attention to this thing unless it's somebody famous, you know, they don't care. So whoever came up with this movie, look, I didn't even read the description of the movie. I just went, honestly, I started watching the movie and I wanted to go in a clean canvas. I didn't want to go. I read some of the comments. When I put it on Netflix, I didn't even read it, the description. I just hit play right away because I want to get into it to see what this what this Don't Look Up movie is all about. But I have to say that I really enjoyed it. It was music to my ear because any kind of resource or media that it gets used to try to educate the citizenry, the we the people, for the people, by the people, I am all for it. And sometimes the entertainment industry, like movies, art and play and all that are the best way to get people to learn, because when we are laughing, we open our heart, we come from a place that we're having fun. So you loosened up a little bit and the information can come through a little bit more, you'll be more accepting. So having fun while you're learning is a must. And this movie for me did that. I thought it was hysterically funny in a lot of the scenes, and it also had a lot of heart. That last scene when they were eating dinner, just about before they're gonna get annihilated, right? I thought it was, oh, that's almost like the Last Supper. There was Christ sitting with his people and he was doing the best he could. He knew the people that betrayed him. He knew the people that are listening to him, that sort of thing. Of course, I'm going that route, but to me, that was the frame of reference. Like, while there is, they did the best they could trying to make the powers that may be aware that this imminent danger was approaching, and we didn't listen. Politics didn't listen. We the people didn't listen. And it wasn't until the end that when they realized, oh, wow, yeah, look at us. Look at how we allow ourselves to be fooled by our government, by the politics, the propaganda. So, mi gente, my people, we American people were quite smart. We don't need political propaganda to try to romance the stone with us to buy the vote. Nowadays, so easy. Get online, check the record. Follow that person. Look at what Puerto Rico did like 2 years ago. What did they do? Well, they didn't like the governor, and this United States territory got together 3.5 something million people, and they're booting him out. Exactly. They didn't even want to wait for another re-election or to get someone to replace it. No, you're done, you're out. We here in the mainland America, trust me people, we can do that if we wanted to. This is not only like it's only for Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico is a US territory. And if the people of Puerto Rico, the American people of Puerto Rico were able to remove an elected representative that it was not serving them right in America, mainland USA, we can do the same. Listen up, mi gente. But anyway, having shared this, Manny and Carlos, I love the movie. I hope I don't. I'm going to say Spanglish, pistofiar. I'm going to pistofiar you both. You mean pissed off. I don't want to piss off anybody. So I said in Spanish, pistofiar. So no se me pistofeen, eh? But yes, the movie was a lot of fun. I think it is a great tool to educate people. Another movie, just before I sign off, that I would like to share with you guys, that is another parody and comedy that reflects the state of affairs of the country, our government, when it comes to ethnic minorities and immigrants and our essential workers that move our food supply chain. Hello, people. Hello. It's One Day Without a Mexican. That's another movie. Oh, my God. Whenever I do cultural intelligence, I like to use that movie as a reference because it has so many, many, many of our social affairs and issues, matters of the public affairs, government, when it comes to the immigrant population. And it's a funny, historically satire. And I think you guys should watch it too, just like you should watch Don't Look Up. But look at it from a point of educational tool. That unfortunately, I hate to burst anyone's bubble, but that's the state of affairs country right there. Those movie shows, what we, the American people, we the people for the people, are allowing to happen. And we just sit at home, get on social line, we make comment, but are we actually checking out the public record of your elected official? What is your mayor doing for you? Your senator, your congressman, those are the people that you need to keep an eye on. That's right, mi gente. Follow the public record, and that's how you're going to learn the character of your elected official. So having said that, go watch that movie. Manny, you're right. We're going to make that movie popular for a different reason. No, maybe perhaps the reason they want it, but I will use it as an educational tool for political scientists to relate to people that perhaps don't understand the background, how the government politics works. It's a great tool to educate people, the same way One Day Without a Mexican and so many others. So having said that, I'm gonna hit another pulse on my coquito. I don't have to try a cup of coquito myself. Acknowledge your ancestor and ask them. I am here to receive all the guidance that I need. I am willing, ready, and able. You go. So here is my finished coquito. This is from 2 days ago. Now that you guys saw me blending that for the last time. I'm gonna put it right in here. Ooh, that coquito is going to be delicious. Delish, delish, delish. Yeah. So, here we go. Put it right in here. I love to put it in pretty bottles. I put bows or ribbons, and I like to give it as a present to my fairy people. Now this is going to go to the refrigerator. And I think I'm done. And I'm going to leave having a little bit of coquito. And then this is from 2 days ago. Ooh, look at that. Nice and smooth. That's how I like it. And this is how I like to drink it, in a little kind of flute glass. So, mi gente, salud. Un brindis por el año nuevo, por el año que se fue, por todas las bendiciones que recibieron, por las que van a recibir, por las que van a declarar. Hablen en pasado, past tense, en tiempo de pasado. Por ejemplo, si se quieren comprar un carro nuevo, digan, ay, qué bien, me encantó el carro que me compré y cómo se sentía tan rico manejando. Así es como uno manifiesta rápido. Sí, no de hablar en el pasado, no de hablar, ay, si me compré el carro y me gusta cómo se siente, me gusta el olor a leather, I love the leather smell. Así es como uno manifiesta, conectando el corazón con los deseos de tu corazón y sentirlo sin duda, como que ustedes están creando la imagen de un creador, de una creadora. No se olviden de eso, que las escrituras cristianas se lo dicen todo el tiempo. ¿Por qué? Why would you question that? Hello, people. Welcome, mi gente. Bueno, con mucho cariño y con mucho amor, aquí les brindo, enviándole mucho amor, mucha salud y muchas bendiciones. Que Dios me los bendiga. Salud. Oh, man, this is good. No wonder my friends like my coquito. Two of these, you're done for the evening. But anyway, go watch that movie. Don't look up. And at least approach it like, what can I learn from this movie that can make me be a better citizen as an American for my country? So I can get more mindfully, civically engaged in your community politics. Don't listen to propaganda. Trust me, they're designed to confuse you, to create xenophobia, and that's not the way a government should be run. We should be running like our constitution, we the people for the people, not just a few people that you give them the vote. You don't even know what these people are all about. Trust me. I know there's a lot of honest and hardworking politicians. I know a few, I have met a few, but the vast majority, mi gente, if you spare the rod, you're spoiling the child. That's just the way it is. So let's get to work and let's be good parents to our elected representative. So con eso los dejo. So Manny, I como te entiendo, como te digo, entiendo tu perspectiva. I support it. I also understand Carlos. But the way I see it, hey, any way that we can educate our people, especially our community, so they can get a awakening as to how actually politics work, this movie does a pretty good job. So look at it from that space. I see it as a parody, a satire, and an excellent educational tool so we can really see how politics, because they did an excellent job. I've been around legislative body, and a lot of those scenes that they will play, a lot of them, they were singing happy birthday to the staff while people are waiting to meet with the, trust me, all that stuff happens and more. Pues mi gente, lo dejo con eso. You have a great day. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And feliz año nuevo. O feliz año viejo. Todavía estamos en el año. Feliz año viejo. Pero les deseo un bonito, bendito, bonito, feliz año nuevo, lleno de bendiciones, de amor, de paz, de alegría y de mucha, mucha gracia. Que Dios me los bendiga. ¡Chao! Y hasta pronto.